Yes.
Sherman?
Yes.
Tucker?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Hanson? Stratton?
Yes.
Do that before, and everybody look at the meeting minutes from October. Those that were here, tell us if anything needs changed. Other than that, Matt was both here and absent.
I'm super here.
So, all I said.
That's a big part of it.
No.
That was the day you were texting me while I was driving.
You marked it absent, and then anyone came in and forgot.
Hour into a 16-hour drive.
Make a motion to approve the minutes.
Been moving secondly to approve the minutes, roll call vote.
Glass?
Yes.
Sherman?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Stratton?
Yes.
Tucker?
Yes.
Financial statements from October. Anything that needs clarification, Courtney?
I don't see what it was to address.
Secondly, to approve the October financials, roll call vote.
Sherman?
Yes.
Lee?
Yes.
Stratton?
Yes.
Tucker?
Yes.
Glass?
Yes.
Smith?
Yes.
I will, so Mr. Barrows doesn't have to suffer through this, but if you want to go ahead and talk about what you'd like to discuss, and then I can go over the things that I need.
I approached Courtney and wrote down eventually at the city about making a donation on behalf of or through the name of Kids and Cops program, which puts all that's version international soccer park service. So anyway, then I asked him to make this donation and get something in return for my taxes. So yeah, give it to me. So anyway, I brought that paperwork. Two bowls, 12 pennies, Brandon and Spawn here. Several guys and some young kids. Maybe in the future it will grow. So anyway, that's why I came here. Get something that I can turn into my account at the end of the year.
I think that's something that Lisa will have to come from your office down there.
Yes.
Yeah. but we found that running north or south is probably better suited for us.
I don't think we had,
there wasn't anything here.
No, a couple of, that ball is weighted to where it does not incline. You can get it hard.
You purposefully kick it up in the air?
You can get it up there, but it doesn't, it's not like a soccer.
So anybody who has concerns, we have any calls over here. It doesn't bounce. It's very slight now. You can't, you know, like a basketball or something will come up. That thing is dead. So it's made that way on purpose. Smaller bowl. Yeah, we didn't have anything. There's no throwing ball. There's a three-line rule. You can't kick it past three lines for the center line. We use the two volleyball lines. The ball goes over three lines. It's turned over. So you have to keep it. Goalies aren't allowed to drop kick it. So I don't know. I can't throw it out. I have to roll it out.
And this is how most kids learn around the world, have to develop new foot skills at a young age, which is why we qualify for the World Cup.
Sundays, so.
Yeah, you get it.
But in all cases, I'll play any Sunday. In fact, you know, Brandon and I talk about it. We'd like to really work with the kids to play. And there is a very real possibility of being able to play tournaments here in the future if we get a line for it. I think we have to walk a referee until it gets better. So, you know, some of the rules that it'd be easy to draw.
And we do have, like Allie's age, we do have a competitive soccer girl driving me to play. So it would be good.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. That's okay.
And they play every Saturday morning.
Over there.
Yeah. So it would be very nice if they could get the rotation on right every time.
Well, the futsal goals are called like the tennis courts. I have those. Look at those score checks. Still there. So, yeah. It's a good alternative to running a whole 120-yard field by 70-yard wide fields.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Coach, we appreciate the donation.
You know where I
live.
I'm there 20 hours a day.
Every little bit I should say is thank you.
Okay, I don't really have much to report. We have started competitive basketball. We've gone 2 weekends. Everything's gone really, really smooth. This coming weekend, we'll start our rec league camps. We can go for 4 weeks. I've got 49 little first and second graders and then 24 older kids, so it's a pretty good group. We'll start that 8 o'clock Saturday morning, and then our competitive then we'll start a little bit ago until, I think this weekend we go until 8, so busy weekends. That's what I want to improve. Anybody have anything for me? Oh, guess not. Hold on, not that. The baseball fields, they've been completed. I'm very happy with the work that was done. So does.
Cool truck, basketball.
We only had one small issue, and I had to call the irrigation guy back into me because when he left, everything was programmed correctly, but when Daryl had to put the scoreboards back up and hook the electricity, something happened, so it wasn't programmed correctly. So he's coming back, so that way it's all programmed to, it will only show, only 4 stations come on right now, and there's only 4 stations on the board that it's not working on. So we are, you know, putting a little bit of water on as best we can. We actually sure put too much water on, and we'll say this is down, so we'll run the water until it gets too cold. We can't run it anymore. Hopefully the sod will take it, hopefully the overseeding and everything will take it. So.
northeast baseball field. You know, when Matt moved that fence in, the scoreboard never got moved in.
Yeah, that scoreboard's in, the southeast one is not.
And they moved something.
Yeah.
And so we're gonna move it in?
Well, yes, and it was kind of, it was an error on my part when Kelly came to fix the scoreboards. That wasn't one that was tilted, but we went in.
What is your emergency one up on?
Yeah, it's at southeast one, yeah. But we do have the, we do have electrical line run up to the fence, so it'll be, we'll have to worry about that, because that's where we put the irrigation blocks. Daryl did that for me.
Anything from city council?
We're in the process of accepting bids for the water tank project up on Young Street, which after the pump station earthquake was in, helped with the pressure problems out here. Yeah, they bypassed them. I think they started pumping from another, but that's a temporary fix. And so they projected start dates in January, I think, and they're looking at like 200 and something day project to get the whole torn down.
Well, no, this is shade structures. This is what the color of the shade structures will be. And so that's, we have to match it pretty darn good. They are going to start bringing in material on Friday. I'm not sure exactly when the project will get started, but the material is going to be starting to come in on Friday. So we're going to start getting along on that. I don't anticipate it being too much longer before we actually start construction. But I can't give you guys a date on that.
Okay. New business. Your turn.